A sad picture.
As the condition of the sanitarium was presented before me in vision, an angel of God seemed to conduct me from room to room in the different departments. The conversation I was made to hear in the rooms of the helpers was not of a character to elevate and strengthen mind or morals. The frivolous talk, the foolish jesting, the meaningless laugh fell painfully upon the ear. I was astonished as I saw the jealousy indulged, and listened to the words of envy, the reckless talk, which made angels of God ashamed. Words and actions and motives were recorded, and how little did these light, superficial heads and hard hearts realize that an angel of God stood at the door, writing down the manner in which these precious moments were employed. God will bring to light every word and every action. He is in every place. These messengers, although unseen, are visitors in the bedchamber. The hidden works of darkness will be brought to light. The thoughts, the intents, the purposes of the heart will stand revealed. All things are naked and open to the eyes of Him with whom we have to do. I was conducted to a few rooms from which came the voice of prayer. How welcome was the sound! A bright light shone upon the face of my guide as his hand traced every word of the petition. The eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are open unto their prayers. 1 Peter 3:12. Disagreeable criticism. From still other rooms came the most disagreeable sallies of low wit and vain talk. Some were making sport of individuals, and even imitating the words uttered in meeting. Sacred things were made the object and subject of jest. Young men and young women were severely criticized. Courtship and marriage were dwelt upon in a low, disgusting manner. There was scarcely a serious word spoken. The conversation was of a character to debase the mind and taint the morals, and all retired without committing themselves to God.